Welcome everyone for our 18 weeks program during this Chaturmas, the special divine period, which started on day of Guru Purnima. And the theme of this program is healthy, happy, and peaceful life. And our focus is mainly on the seven steps. It's based on the Bhagavad Gita and 108 mantras of my books. But whole Bhagavad Gita has been put together in simple seven steps. And that's why sometimes I repeat those steps just to relate to it. And again, welcome everyone. I am Satya Kalra, your host and founder of Path to Anandam, Path to Blissful Living, Blissful Life. And that's where the focus is, how to attain, experience love, peace, Anandam. As you can see from this logo, it says love, peace, Anandam. Through the teachings of Bhagavad Gita, through the mantras of Om, through the many other spiritual practices, but they are all consist, or the Bhagavad Gita offers all those teachings. And pranam to Guruji, Guruji, unko Hariharji Maharaj, who motivated me, blessed me to write all these books. And with his blessings, all the books became number one bestseller on Amazon. And all these teachings are based on many things taken from these books and my experiences through meditation, through in the external world, and also counseling other people. And as you know, I am also a self-transformation coach, happiness coach. So based on a lot of experiences, this study session has been put together. And today's subject is go beyond your limitations through again seven steps. Some of the steps will repeat because they're all based on the Bhagavad Gita, but they're specifically for that particular subject. And during this session, we will cover, it is based on the gunas. So what are gunas? How many types of gunas? What is the relationship of gunas, us, and this maya, this nature, prakriti? What are the effects of guna in our life? And how to go beyond it? Again, seven steps. And what are the benefits of becoming gunatit? And what are the hallmarks of gunatit person? How to practice it in daily life? Meditation and the tip of the day. All these teachings of Bhagavad Gita are based on the application, not just reading. And somebody sent me very beautiful, and I have already posted it on our group, where it says Bhagavad Gita was told to twice. One, read it. And you can see there was no impact on him. But so impact on Arjuna by listening to Bhagavad Gita. We all know that. Initially he said, "Na jyotasya iti gobindam," I will not fulfill my responsibilities even though I had to fight. And at the end he says, "Karishye vachanam tav," I will do as you advise. So this is the impact of applying the teachings of Bhagavad Gita. Only listening and reading have a certain impact, but unless we applied it in our life, we practice it, the impact we will not experience it, and we will not feel the full freedom of our miseries, from our miseries of life. And this is where Hariharji Maharaj says, Gita is a step-by-step spiritual and practical guide for self-purification, self-transformation, and self-realization. Means experiencing that I am Satchitananda. I am no different than God. And again, we start with the very first teachings of Bhagavad Gita, where Arjuna accepted his agony, his misery. He was very open, no ego. Simply he said, Karpanya dosho pahat swabhava, paschami tvam dharma sammool cheta, yachase yani nishchitam bruhi tanme shishyaste ham shadi mam tvam prapannam. He asked Lord Krishna that I cannot make the decision right now what to do and what not to do because my mind is very disturbed. Please guide me what is necessary to do for me, what is correct for me, what is right for me. Whole Gita teaches us righteousness, practice the righteousness in our life. And that's where Arjuna is asking Lord Krishna, please guide me what to do. And that is the step number one in our life. Be aware of it, the status of our mind. Before even I do, we do not just for the godly things or puja part. Anything we do in our life, we must be aware of it. Where am I? What I want to do? What are my resources? That is the teaching of Bhagavad Gita, very first chapter. And then if need the advice, ask your superiors, your counselors, your experience, gurus, if you find them, whoever you feel comfortable with. But you must have a full faith in them. And then analyze, like Arjuna, analyze it here. That I cannot perform. So by listening to Arjuna's request, when he says, Shishyaste ham shadi mam tvam prapanyam, I'm your disciple, please guide me. Lord Krishna advises him. And he tells him that I know you are depressed, you are fearful, you are worried, which is called Vishad. You are flooded with the poison, toxins in your system. So let me tell you what you need to do. You basically transcend yourself and you have to uplift yourself. And he says, in this beautiful verse, Triguna Vishya Veda, Nistray Guna Bhav Arjuna, Nirdvando Nitsatvasto, Niryog Shem Atman. Vedas deal with the three modes of gunas. O Arjuna, transcend these gunas. Go beyond these gunas. Free yourself from duality, from your limitations, anxiety, pain, and be established in the Supreme Self, means focus in the Supreme Power. Focus in the Supreme Consciousness. Live in the Supreme Consciousness. Then Arjuna gets very confused. He doesn't know what gunas are. What is he talking about? So just by looking his expression on the face, Lord Krishna tells him, explains him, what are gunas? Gunas are our attributes, our innate qualities, jisko hum kehte hain hamara swabhav, prakriti, mother nature. This is all gunas. And there are three types of gunas. Tamasik or tamas, rajas, sattvas. And tamas stands for ignorance, darkness. and rajas, passion, and goodness. Sattva is goodness, purity, light. And we are the byproduct of our gunas, cause and effect. We are sent on this earth by supreme power to go beyond our gunas, tamasic, rajasic, sattvic, even beyond sattvic. So what are the characteristics of gunas in detail? The tamasic, darkness, laziness, inertia, heaviness, ignorance, mainly the ignorance, don't know what to do and what not to do. Good example, terrorists. They do what they are taught to. They do not have a buddhi, vivek, whether it should be done or not, based on their religious activities or based on whatever the causes they have. And sometimes we don't know what to do. Sometimes we are very depressed. Sometimes we don't know what to do. At that time, tamasic nature has taken over on us. The next one is the rajasic, the person who is very passionate, wants to do everything according to his desires, his whatever he, very desirous person, flooded with the desires. Passion. The problem is when they are passionate about their whatever they want to do it, they could be dishonest. They could stab other people on their back. Kisi ka kuch bhi bigaar sakte hain wo, kyunki unko jo kuch paana hai apne paane ke liye, wo kuch bhi kar sakte hain. The saying in English is, he or she could sell her mother for money or whatever the reasons are. These are very money motivated, very selfish people. But the beauty of these people, all these gunas are not bad. If we use them properly, the beauty of rajas is, it is called fire in the belly. These are the people who are very active too. Bill Gates, you name it, people. The big tycoons, CEOs, they are very much into rajasic nature. The only problem is when they cross the fine line and not use the rajasic nature or passion for getting the work done, but they start doing it so selfish, like companies, they try to destroy small companies, large companies, they usually do that. They want to destroy because they want to become bigger and bigger and bigger and very greedy. So these people are very greedy, filled with tamasic nature, kaam, krodh, lobh, moh, ankar. And the sattvic people, very simple, down to earth, focus on the welfare of the universe, sarvabhut hitarata. They are very balanced. They are very harmonious, very kind, very open, very flexible. If you give them any suggestion, they take it with blessing of God. Because their ego is very minimized. So the tamasic people, in simply I say, who give takleef to dusron ko, bina soche samjhe. Rajasic people who want to live like rajas, kingdom, but everybody is not like a raja in Janak. Many people are who want to conquer everything for themselves. So that's where the rajasic nature is. And sattvic people, selfless, simple. But I would say sadhu, lekin aajkal sadhuon ka bhi thoda naam thoda kahin acche hai kahin kharab hai, to sadhu kehne mein bhi aadmi ko ghabrahat hoti hai ki pata nahi uska kya meaning liya jaye. But basically they are the saints. Saints means they are very pure inside, because the sattvic is the light. It makes you light, even not just to give you the glory of light, it makes you light. And good is a good distinction is that, and little story here is that three robbers were in a jungle. They found a one man, simple man who was walking around, and they caught him. So they were thinking, ab iska kya kiya jaye? So tamasic person immediately says, let's kill him. अपने तामसिक नेचर की वजह से. राजसिक पर्सन सेज नो डोंट किल हिम बट उसको बांध दो, रस्सी से बांध के उसको पेड़ से बांध दो. एंड सात्विक पर्सन सेड नहीं, उसको शहर में जाके छोड़ के आ जा. सो ये है तीनों का मेंटल एटीट्यूड. और ये gunas, as I said, they are not bad. We all need these three gunas. Sone ke liye humko tamasic nature chahiye. Tabhi usko tamasic devi bhi kehte hain. Nindra ko tamasic devi, kyunki nindra ke bina hum perform nahi kar sakte hain. Rajasic nature chahiye, nahi to hum apni life ko maintain kaise karenge? Maintenance to chahiye na. To uske liye humko ab kaam karna hai, sab kuch karna hai. लेकिन सेल्फलेसली करना है. तो राजसिक नेचर भी चाहिए और फिर सात्विक नेचर तो चाहिए ही चाहिए. सो इसके लिए प्रोपोर्शन है. यूजुअली वुमेन आर मोर सात्विक, सात्विक कंसीडर टू बी. और राजसिक नेचर 20%, 10%, एंड देन मेल द सिमिलरली. बट व्हाट हैपेंस नाउअडेज, सात्विकनेस तो बहुत कम हो गई है. एन एवरेज पर्सन, पीपल हैव बिकम वेरी सेल्फिश एंड दैट्स व्हाई देयर सात्विकनेस इज ओनली 5-10%. राजसिक इज गॉन अप डाउन डिपेंडिंग, बट तामसिक हैज इंक्रीज्ड ट्रिमेंडसली इन पीपल. एंड नॉट ओनली दैट, द ड्यूरिंग द डिफरेंट टाइम ऑफ द डे, इन द मॉर्निंग व्हेन वी आर काम, as we all experience, the sattvic nature dominates. During the day, the rajasic nature dominates. And at night time, tamasic nature dominates. And it all depends on our mind, our status of mind. Ki din mein wo rajasic ki tarah ghumta, you can see it going here. At night, it is as the tamasic. And when we are really calm, spiritually oriented, we are very balanced. So people's behavior depends on the ratio of the tamasic, rajasic, and sattvic, how much they carry. So as I said, tamasic 10%, rajasic 20%, and sattvic should be 70%. But it has gradually decreases. So 20, 20, 60, 30, 30, 40, you can see all those. And this is a today's man. Most of the not. So ratio of tamasic, rajasic, and sattvic is the behavior. You can judge by people's behavior how much tamasic and rajasic and sattvic they carry and how ethical these people are. And it's not just the people. The whole universe is made with tamasic, rajasic, and sattvic. In simply tamasic bad, rajasic in between, and the sattvic is good. So good, bad, good, and super good. So people are three types. We all know that. Even our thoughts, sometimes hamare thoughts bahut kharab aa jate hain. Then sometimes between rehte hain, sometimes bahut acche hote hain. Intellect, Gita, this is all coming from Gita and it is in chapter 17, so well described these things. So please refer that to chapter 17. This is a summary of whole tamasic, rajasic, sattvic, gunas. In Bhagavad Gita, gunas, Lord Krishna mentioned 36 times. Out of that, some are in chapter 2. And it's all over, everywhere you will see it in the Bhagavad Gita. Gunas, 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 because we perform based on our gunas, based on our swabhav. But in chapter 14, 17 and chapter 18 up to 4, six, verse 41, all talks about Triguni Maya, Tamsik, Raisik, Satvik. So there it talks about ki gunas, there are intellect is three types. So buddhi bhi kharab hoti hai, achhi hoti hai, aur bhot achhi hoti hai. Food is tamsik, ye to hum sabhi jante hai, koi tamsik food hai, koi ठीक जो राइसिक लोग जो जिसे कहते हैं पक्का खाना जो हम लोग खासकर त्योहारों पर खाते हैं और आई राखी के दिन भी बहुत लोग खाएंगे तो दिस इज राइसिक फूड एंड सात्विक फूड हम सब जानते हैं लिव ऑन फ्रूट्स वेजिटेबल्स एंड फूड विद द प्रेयर्स एंड एक्शन ब्रीदिंग ईटिंग टॉकिंग वॉकिंग स्लीपिंग दिस इज ऑल बेस्ड ऑन कि हम योग निद्रा में सोते हैं कि हम रेगुलर नींद में सोते हैं जिसमें कभी नाइटमेयर्स आते हैं कभी कुछ होता है और कभी हम इतने परेशान होकर सोते हैं कि हमको हमारी नींद नहीं आती है दैट इज तामसिक स्लीप फेथ कभी फेथ भी हमारा जो होता है बहुत अच्छा पक्का भगवान में या इतना भरोसा होता है कभी कुछ गड़बड़ होती है तो हमारा फेथ गेट्स डामाडोल हो जाता है एंड देन समटाइम्स certain things happen and humko lagta hai bhagwan ji ye sab theek nahi hai bhagwan ji aap kahan ho you know you just kind of lose the true faith in it worship bhi koi sirf spirits ki bhoot preton ki puja karte hain to koi apni pet puja karte hain to koi apna kuch puja karte hain lekin asli puja kya hai when we are live in the consciousness of god live every moment in the awareness of the divinity aur charity daan bhi jo hota hai तीन तरह का होता है जैसे कि कुछ लोग तो दान बिना सोचे समझे जिसने मांगा दे दिया आई एम द गिल्टी ऑफ इट आई मेरे से जो भी पहले दान मांगता था मैं सोचती नहीं थी मैं दे देती थी लेटर ऑन आई लर्न कि दिस इज द रॉन्ग बिकॉज दे कुड यूज आवर डोनेशंस इन ए मिस यूज इट और उसका पाप भी हमको ही लगता है सो वी हैव टू बी वेरी उसमें गीता में लिखा है कि कैसा दान देना चाहिए सो दान वहां देना चाहिए वेयर यू नो एग्जैक्टली व्हाट इज हैपनिंग देयर हाउ द योर रिसोर्सेज आर बीइंग यूज्ड इंक्लूडिंग दान का मतलब सिर्फ मनी नहीं है अपना टाइम अपना अपना ज्ञान अपना ऐसी जगह देना चाहिए तभी श्री कृष्ण भगवान जी कहते हैं उसको ज्ञान मत दो गीता मत सुनाओ जो कि जिन जो मुझसे नफरत करते हैं या पीपल आर नॉट इंटरेस्टेड अदरवाइज दे विल जस्ट गेट इनटू आर्गुमेंट दिस नॉलेज बिकम्स एज अ तामसिक नॉलेज फॉर देम सो और कुछ लोग दान करते हैं अपना नेम एंड फेम के लिए जैसे कि आप जाओगे तो बहुत जगह आश्रम्स में भी जाओगे तो कमरों पर भी नाम लिखे हैं पंखों पर भी नाम लिखे हैं हर चीज में नाम लिखे हैं क्योंकि दे आर लुकिंग फॉर नेम एंड फेम एंड आई नो सर्टेन पीपल उनसे दे आस्क कि If I give this donation, would you bring me on the stage during the conference to announce that this is a donation or I have sponsored this part? Or mera naam newspaper mein aayega, ye nahi aayega. This is all Raisik donations. But people jo gupt daan dete hain, ya they know ki kahan exactly that is the charity of Satvik. So you can, we will go over, but due to the shortage of time, I will not cover everything here, but basically goal of life or hamari lifestyle kaisi hai, that is very, very important. Goal of life, ye nahi hai ki humko sirf itna sab materialistic world, we have to accumulate all these things, but we have to experience by seva. We have to do the seva to this prakriti, jisne Bhagwan ne पैदा किया है गॉड हैज ब्रॉट अस टू दिस वर्ल्ड टू हेल्प अदर्स एज वेल सत्य साई बाबा सेज लव ऑल सर्व ऑल हेल्प एवर हर्ट नेवर वी शुड ऑलवेज रिमेंबर दैट एंड आवर लाइफ स्टाइल शुड बी सात्विक रादर देन वेरी राइसिक going enjoying too many parties and all that we should because the next day humko problem hoti hai and all that so we should do that it's not that we should become an anti and we should not socialize it but we should keep a balance but by looking at it as we can see everything in the world in the universe is made with three gunas good bad and super good or bad good and super good tamasic, rajasic, sattvic. But we should always know, Gita mein Bhagwan kehte hain ki we are slave of our gunas. We are made with gunas. Hamari body, hamara jo janm hua hai, we are born because based on our karmas. So our karmas are performed based on our gunas. And it also says that by living, what are the other, one of the things Lord Krishna explains so well in Bhagavad Gita, and he says, the people who live the tamasic life, what is their future? They go into animal kingdom. They become animal in their next life. And for example, jaise kehte hai na, ki the people who verbally abuse like this, ki kutte ki tarah bhogta hai. They say, must be kutte ka janm hoga iska pehle ka. And then he thinks he might become a dog again because he's barking like that. So they go to a lower kingdom. But at the same time, rajasic people again go middle. Maybe they go into human life, whatever they get. But the sattvic people even, they go to heaven. And when their good karmas are exhausted, they come back. So good karmas take us to certain, so you know, just like we are in the train and we go into, get off in a different stations. Jisko ki Garuda Puran mein aur many other humare shastron mein, it says different lokas. So basically, one goes to different lokas based on the life we style we live here. This is basically a summary of gunas, which talks about attributes, chapter 6 to 8, 14 verse to 68. So this is a summary of Bhagavad. It is in my book, My Question and God's Answer. And as I mentioned, this has been used in UC Berkeley, in many universities, in the course of ethics. And this is a beautiful, this is so useful, this table. Here it says tamasic, rajasic, sattvic, which verses are tailored toward each category. So here is work action, what kind of action we should be performing, what kind of worship, what kind of food, what kind of yagnas we should be doing, what kind of tapas we should be doing, and what kind of tyag we should be doing, gyan, knowledge, kaisa hai, doership. This is so important, what kind of things we should be doing, and not do's and don'ts. And happiness and pleasure. What, we get the happiness just by certain doing certain worldly things, and that's very temporary. Then we go to the next level of happiness by sometime we go to party, we enjoy it, we buy things and we enjoy it, but later on it's temporary and we pay the consequences as well. But the permanent happiness, just I call it anandam. Where do we get the anandam? But anandam also has a limitation, because it can take us only to swarg, heaven, unless we go and experience, because this anandam is we are experiencing in this life, day-to-day life. But unless we reach to the sat-chit ananda, that is the paramdham, and that's where it teaches. So you can see it here, tamasic, we have our job is here. This is where the tamasic nature is, anger, attachment, greed. And this is tamasic and rajasic, basically greed, insomnia. This is basically summarize the qualities of the tamasic and rajasic, where a lot of stress, lot of disasters or diseases, hatred. Basically, again, kaam, krodh, lobh, moh, ankar, jealousy, resentment. But the thing is, most of the people, most of us, I would say, or most of the people live in a rajasic nature. But one has to put an extra effort not to go down to the tamasic and uplift in a sattvic nature. And then, of course, go beyond your limitations, means go beyond the our become a gunatit. So this is how we transcend. So how to transcend? This is a simple ignorance to passion, to goodness, and then to godliness. So how to transcend it continues. I use AAA strategy, and that is self-awareness, self-analysis, and then action for correction. And the focus of each subject is we focus on the action of correction for that particular subject we take. But this is again the same, transforming our mind, which means take all the garbage out of our mind, reprogram our mind. And so purity of mind, purity of speech, body, triple purity, jisko ki Gita mein tap kaha hai. And those taps are in chapter 17, 14, 15, 16. And sharir ka tap, we should, it says, dev dwij guru prage pujanam. Ahimsa. Brahmacharya. Shreer tap uchyate. Usko shreer ka tap bolte hain. Jab hum ahimsa practice karte hain. Selflessness practice karte hain. Then it says vani ka tap. Anudvek karam vakyam satyam parhitam cha. Swadhyay abhyasnam vanmai tap uchyate. Vani aisi boliye man ka apak hoye. Oran ko sheetal kare khud bhi sheetal hoye. That is the translation of that verse. But swadhyaya abhyasnam means we should always continue to do the self-inquiry, how we speak, what we do. And then man ka mind ka tap. Man ne somatmam. Monam atma vinigraha. When we are upset, we should be quiet rather than becoming abusive, verbally abusive to others. This is what this says, mind, bhava shuddhir. Always have a best intention. And that's what it is called, vanmai tapuchyate, or shariram tapuchyate, and monam, manka. So all these, I call it, make a best use of your body, make a best use of your vani, and make a best use of your thoughts. Because Gita mein uska phir kaha hai, dhyayato vishan punsa sangasteshu upjayate, sanga sanjayate kama kama krodho vijayate, krodha bhakti sammoha sammoha smriti brahmachad, buddhi nasha buddhi, and usse jo hamari buddhi hoti hai, then everything gets distorted. Our buddhi, our mind, everything. And when buddhi ka nash, humara nash. So buddhi branshad, buddhi nasha. So we have to be very careful with our dhyanas, to what we think. So seven steps, focus is, again, I talked about self-awareness, self-analysis, action for correction, and living in a sattvic lifestyle. And of course, yoga, pranayama, meditation, that is a part of our spiritual practices, and we should continue to practice and then do our best and then let it go. So oneness with God through external prakriti and internal connection within prakriti is the divine form of God. This is so important to know this, that whatever we talked, external world, the charity, people, sleep, everything what is external. Prakriti ke through, by practicing, applying the Gita's teaching in this external world, we can uplift, because we cannot just sit and do the meditation and do the mala all the time and connect it with supreme power, because that is the best way to, of course, live in the God consciousness. But every moment connecting with the creation of God, offering our best service, even ki hum prakriti mein, whatever we do every day, we should be offering to God. We are doing everything for God. All the donations are for God. Dealing with people is the offering to God. How Lord Krishna has dealt with Arjuna, this is how we should deal with other people who are distressed. So every teaching of Bhagavad Gita, we should apply and uplift ourselves. Then we can experience. So prakriti, we must use this nature, prakriti, day-to-day life, to uplift ourselves. And now this is a self-awareness. Again, I put it here, how to distinguish and recognize individuals based upon their gunas and characteristics. And it's not just others. How can we also become aware that where are we? We should analyze it. So again, as I said, here, tamasic ke characteristics are here, rajasic ke here, which I already spoke about it, satvic ke are here, and we could judge other people based on this. Who is rajas, who is tamas, who is satvic? This gives us a vivek buddhi. However, and the final question here comes, this guide can be used for self-assessment and self-analysis. So the question is, where do you stand? Where do I stand based on these tamasic, rajasic, sattvic characteristics? And then we should plan to uplift ourselves. So how we are going to practice it? Practice goodness. As I said, think good. I'm forgetting that verse. But here is, again, those tapas. And see good. See, make the best use of our mind. Think good. Then see good. Dusron ki buraiyan dekhne ke badle, we should see good. And in Gita, there is a beautiful verse in this one, which it says, Yo mam pashyati sarvatra, sarvam cha mai pashyati, tasyam na pashyami sachme na pranshati. Sab mein Bhagwan ko dekho. See God in everyone, including yourself. Because we are the creature, the part of the supreme power. We are jeev atma. Body is given to us to uplift ourselves, and atma is the one which is guiding us, connected with the supreme power. Speak good, as I said, anudvek karam vakyam, right here. Hear good. You know, when we are connected with supreme power, it says hear good. We should listen to our inner voice. But it's telling us, we should also, like Lord Krishna, we should listen, 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 listen. When people talk to us, when they're distressed, Lord Arjuna said, Keshav, main bol raha hoon, and aap muskura rahe hain. Main itna distress mein hoon aur aap muskura rahe hain. And Lord Krishna says, pehle tum to bol lo. The lesson here is, let other people speak before we open our mouth for our advices, and then do good. Do good. This is basically, hum sabhi jante hain, do good ka matlab hai karmanyavadi ka raste. Lekin isse zyada aur bhi, chapter 4 ki verse 17 mein Bhagwan ji ne kaha hai ki we should know what is vikarma, forbidden action jo humko nahi karni chahiye, what is karma which we are doing all the time. These are the karmas. And what is a karma? When we work or use work as a worship, to usk work, then there is a no precautions. There are no results. There is no cause and effect of that karma. So we should focus to do on a karma. And we should know what is the karma, what is karma, and what is a karma. Because it also says, कर्मों की गति बहुत गहरी है. So we don't know where our karmas are coming from and where will it lead us. So we should put a conscious effort to know the distinction. So practicing goodness leads to godliness, and godliness leads to unity. So goodness leads to godliness, divinity, and then do unity. And what does unity means? Unity means supreme peace. Anandam, experiencing Satchitananda. But I just put it this again, though I had shown it last week. The relationship of our body, senses, mind, intellect, and spirit, how they are connected, and then how we should practice all this goodness to not be controlled by our senses, not be controlled our mind, but we should be the master of our mind, and we should listen to our supreme power messages, and our buddhi will be get clean and purified. So transcend, reprogram your mind through controlling our mind, our senses, because most of our senses are right in the head portion. Kaan, naak, ears, eyes, mouth, tongue, everything is there. So that's why I put these five monkeys: think good, see good, hear good, speak good, in good. And these are basically given for each individual one, which we have already spoken for it. So we will bypass this one. And again, we have also spoken about the do good, about the karma, vikarma, karma also. But basically, we should practice the righteous action, art. And then, of course, take care of ourselves. Without that, body, mind, and soul, we have to make sure that our body is functioning. So in Atharva Veda, it says, everyone should work hard to achieve success, growth, prosperity, living in this world. But this can be possible only when our health is good. So we have to make sure that our health, we take good care of our health, and then it becomes healthy body, healthy mind, happy and peaceful life. And again, I put it here, which I put it in every session, which is very, very important to practice from the morning to night. In the morning, have mantras, whatever affirmations, or thank you, God, whatever we want to do it. Study scriptures. It's so important to study scriptures in the morning. Even we take a one verse, it sets the trend of our mind, direction of our mind for the day. And then if we can do yoga, pranayama, meditation, prayers in the morning to strengthen our body, strengthen our lungs, and connect with the supreme power, and then take a practice. You know, here I put one item. I put an example here, but adat buri sudhar lo. Kaun si adat aaj humko sudharni hai? Let's focus on that. Don't get bombarded with too many things. Just take one thing at a time. Oneness with God will come only by doing one thing. So take a one thing, whatever bothers us at that day, practice it. And then in the evening, just evaluate ourselves, how we did it, made it, and then let go. So spiritual practices lead to self-transformation, eternal happiness, anandam, external body. And again, here is the practices, I put it here. Here is a calendar. If you need, you can download this calendar from my website, pathvanandam.org. It is there. And then you can just say, just have a 30 days program, because most of my books have a 30 days program. So I always put this calendar for practices. If I want to change one habit, whatever is that, and sometimes one habit requires a whole month to practice. So how I did it in the morning, how did it in the evening, and just, you know, just have a discipline. Make it, this is more, I call it a practicing lifestyle of, or living in a sattvic lifestyle. So again, this is, what are the benefits of it? Transcending ourselves. And Lord Krishna summarizes it very beautifully in chapter 14, 20, verse 20 and 26. When one transcends the three guna, that creates the body, which means we are the byproduct of our body. One is free from the path, pain of birth, old age, death, pains, miseries, and can enjoy the supreme bliss. Even in this lifetime, after day-to-day life becomes easier, more enjoyable, and also attain immortality. So ignorance, we lead from ignorance to passion, to godliness, to goodness, sattvic lifestyle, and then ultimately supreme peace. So happy, healthy, and blissful life. I put this here. This is the benefit. Another benefit. We become gunati. We become free from all, because these are the characteristics of a gunati person, means the person becomes equanimous. Lord Krishna, this equanimity, samta, he had said 68 times in Bhagavad Gita, samta, 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 samta. We have to learn how to be equanimous. So he starts with that, mistrei guna bhav Arjuna. Arjuna, free yourself from guna, become the gunati. And then he says, man apuman yastulle, yastulle, mitra aparishayo, sarva arambh parityagi, gunatit sa uchyate. What does gunatit means? Gunatit means the person who is free from gunas, means who is pain and pleasure, kabhi khush, kabhi khushi, kabhi gam, kabhi dukh, kabhi gam. Go through it, but without complaining. Why me? And praise and criticism, tarif, don't look for the praises or don't look for the and not be disturbed by the criticism. We have to observe that. When somebody praises, then what happens to our body? Our ego gets up. Feel it. And if ego is getting up, there is some sensation is changed in the body, means our ego is acting at that time. And then partiality, equal to friends and foes. Doership, I am not the doer. God is the one who is asking me to do this work. And free from all, basically free from all these, what we just spoke. And the person at the state of equanimous is called gunatit person. And these are the hallmarks of the gunatit person. And that should be our motto, to reach there and then attain ultimate happiness, peace, blissful life, anandam. So now the choice is ours. What we want to be here